Zurab, about the Kovalyov incident, you call him a gypsy. Can you just clarify that?
Well, first of all, let's clarify it from the beginning. I use word gypsy, but not calling him gypsy. I use word, you are dressed like gypsy. Of course, that's a common mistake for the people who are in the such a way, some ways we are using some words, and which is absolutely not connecting with them. Insult nationality, for example, that somebody can use that black, or somebody can use the Jewish, or something like that. With the meaning of gypsy, it means the homeless, mainly we are using in our slang language like this. Of course, I really apologize I make such a mistake. So the interpretation of the word was done by different way, like really I insult some nation. That's not true. What I want to say actually, this he dressed like a clown. And only one thing is missing, that for Anton, that with this short pant, he have to use also something on the red, to make a red nose. So this is nothing wrong. I have a meaning of this. Nothing really, you know, it's really crossing my mind when people are thinking like this, I insult some nation. Georgians, first of all, are very tolerant people. You can see in Tbilisi that we have a almost all nations and almost all religions here. So all people will feel comfortable. Even I'm telling you that a lot of Indians we have now in Tbilisi, and they are coming and they feel very well themselves. A lot of people from Nigeria, Jewish people here stayed 3,000 years ago and they continue. Russians with us, even the politics we are fighting. We cannot, Georgian people don't have a tradition to criticize or to insult some nation. There is not in our soul. And what is not in our soul, actually, I cannot, because if I grow up like this, I never grow up as some kind of racist. If somebody try today that I'm a racist, this is wrong approach and they will not succeed this. But I apologize, because this word maybe, you know, for some people or some nations, maybe it's very insulted. So, and the meaning of the word, they interpret it in the differently, and that's why I have to make a clarification of this word, why I use this. And I don't use that you are gypsy again, because then maybe they can consider like that I'm insulting the nation. I use, you are dressed like gypsy, and that's you have to change your clothes. And it was actually after this that he provoked me. He asked me what is wrong in my dress.
And Anton also wrote in his Facebook post that you threatened him with action of FIDE. So he was very afraid, and that is why he left from, in that
sense. FIDE is not a police, yes, first of all. The action of the FIDE, which is absolutely normal, is described in the rules, regulations, contracts, so on. It is clear that FIDE can only punish player financially. It means when we are giving the prize fund, FIDE is giving in this situation, of course, through to organizer, prize fund. It means that for bad behavior, for such a situations when players, it's connecting with dress code or other behavior as well. For example, if you don't go for the interview or something like this, you know the rule that they can be punished by FIDE financially. So I mean this. And I say this because he have to know. Probably when he signed the contract, I'm sure now that he don't read anything from this contract. Even he studied to be lawyer, and he have to know about contracts, everything. So here have to understand which kind of. So I clarified. Just when he using word that I shout, this is not correct again, because my voice unfortunately is very loud. Even. Sometimes that people ask me to speak, you know, a little bit like this. It's not for me, you know. Any kind of word I say, 50 minutes, people will hear about this. So that's not my style. And probably, you know, he want to interpret it in his Facebook that I really shout him. This was not like this. I said in the beginning very politely that Mr. Kovalyov, he turned to me. I again repeat, I said, you have to change your short pants to the normal pants. He said, what is wrong here in my dress? And I said, you are dressed like a gypsy. And then he said that you are somehow insulting me and I will not do it. And then I said that if you will not do it, then the action will be done like this. And that's by law, I think I'm not wrong. But again, I repeat, the word of gypsy, which one I have a different meaning. If somebody feel that is insulted, I really apologize for this. Because I have to use the different word, again, I will somebody clone. So if I speak loudly and somebody thinks that I shout, this is also wrong. I apologize because of my timbre of voice. It's a different one. What I can do more? Unfortunately, he behaved, in my opinion, very bad. Because he insulted the tournament. He insulted tournament which one really organizers give their blood in the tournament. Not only that we fight and we took everything to make conditions for the player, but you know, with this behavior somehow it looks like this, that you are not respecting not only your colleagues there, but also you don't respect organizers. So and, it's really sad for me. I don't like the situation around.
The first two rounds he wore the same shorts and he came and he was not told by the arbiters, and then right 10 minutes before the game, do you think it was correct on the part of the arbiters and yourself to do this?
My opinion is like this. We have a meeting with the arbiters today, actually run by Mr. Jorge Vega. He was the chairman of the meeting. So I say my opinion. I don't hide this from the arbiter. I say that I don't know the name who was there in the first round and second round. This is arbiter's job to clarify. Chief arbiter have to clarify who was the sector arbiter. My job is like this, what I say. The arbiter, sector arbiters, if chief arbiter say that I don't see, I can imagine that, you know, 128 players, probably he have some other duties, how he explained Mr. Delega, and he did not, if he's not getting signal from his sector arbiters, his deputies and etc., I can imagine that he even don't think about that somebody came like this. But again, here I repeat, there is a, if some arbiter is making the mistake, Mr. Chief Arbiter, whom I respect very much, he's my friend and I like him really, but somehow it's his fault also, because we have a team which one is not doing the correct things. And I believe that yesterday accident mainly came from this, that somebody didn't make the action in the first and second round. Somebody, I said, who has a clear visibility of this situation. Of course, for the future, also have to be more clear in FIDE rules, what is the arbiter's, to describe what is the arbiter's job, what sector arbiter is doing, what the deputy arbiter are doing, and so on, so on. Today, it's very difficult to blame or to accuse some people, but in my point of view, listen, we are, FIDE is a democratic organization. I have just my opinion, which one I will say there. But if the majority will say, no, this is a correct, the majority will decide. So, but the majority have to think about this, how to make more clear that to avoid such a kind of things, including the dress code, to say the truth. We analyzed even dress code yesterday. In European Union, we have a clear dress code rules, absolutely clear. Everybody understand what, which right they have and which right they don't have. Here it says some kind of door where you can interpret it from one side or other side. So, but again, I repeat, if chief arbiter is approaching you and he say that this is a rule, you cannot go like this, then this is a rule already in the stage and you have to follow. You cannot accuse the previous rounds, like yesterday happened like this or 1 year happened like this. It starts from this period, and you have to follow this.
So, last question: do you think that 10 minutes before the game was the right time for all of this? He said that if it would have done later on, he would have gone to the.
This is, in my opinion. Again, it's my opinion. What Chief Arbiter did is absolutely right and correct. Doesn't matter even 1 minute before he shot. It can be possible that 1 minute before Mr. Kovalyov came to play his game, correct? Or even is late, because here is not zero tolerance. He can be late for the game. Chief arbiter can say, sorry, you cannot play like this, and go to change. That's a problem of the player. This is not a problem of the chief arbiter. So again, if somebody is building the theory of the conspiracy against the player, this is wrong. Nobody fight against Mr. Kovalyov. Everybody here are concentrate to fight to follow the regulations and rules, nothing more. Even I'm very sorry that today Mr. Carlsen disqualified, but if Carlsen was dressed like this and chief arbitre will not make a separation, there is a mistake. There is no separation in the playing call. They are coming, they are players, respectable players, doesn't matter the title, rating, etc., etc. They have to respect also rules.
Thank you so much.
Thank you as well.